Hello and welcome. I'm Elizabeth, a librarian with the San Jose Public Library, and today we're going to be making a fun mathematical toy, a set of balance scales which we can use to explore weight. For today's activity, you'll need a hanger. This can be a metal or plastic hanger, anything that you have convenient. You also need two containers to form the sides of the scale. You'll need some string to hang the containers with, and something to secure the string to the containers with, rubber bands, binder clips, or even a hole punch that you can use. You also need a straw to serve as the level indicator, as well as tape and scissors. To use the scale, you'll need to assemble some things from around your house to measure. I've got some crayons, pennies, blocks, and rubber balls here. Now we're ready to begin constructing our hanging scales. I'm going to start off with my two containers and a pair of rubber bands. I'm going to stretch the rubber bands around the container just under the rim of the container. These rubber bands will serve as a place for me to tie the strings to my containers so that I can attach them to the hanger. Next, I'm going to cut 6 pieces of string of equal length. These don't need to be any particular length, although if you have very long pieces of string, your scale may be very long as well. I'm just going to use the piece of string to cut all the subsequent pieces of string so that they're the same length, so that the containers won't tilt or be unbalanced. Now that I have my 6 pieces of string, I'm going to tie them around my containers, 3 to a container at an equal distance from each other around the rim of the container. So I'm just going to tie it on with a double knot and then take my next piece of string and move around a third of the container's circumference and attach the piece of string there. Once I have all 3 pieces of string attached to each of my 2 containers, I'm going to bring the 3 pieces of string up and making sure that the container isn't unbalanced so that all of the pieces of string are stretched to the same length, I'm going to tie a knot in the 3 pieces of string. I don't want to tie it too close to the top of the container because that would prevent me from being able to put things into my container. But this will let our containers hang freely and make it easier to attach our containers to our hanger. Now that you have both of your containers, let's take a look at our hanger. I've hung it here from a doorknob, and you can see that the bottom length isn't quite even, so it's a little bit slanted up towards the right here. So we want to make sure that when we attach our indicator straw, that we attach the straw straight up and down, no matter if the bottom of the hanger is exactly even or not. You can see how as the hanger moves, the indicator straw is either straight up and down or tilted to one side. Ready to attach our 2 containers to either side of our hanger to complete our scales. You can slide the hangers along the bottom bar of the scale until the level indicator is completely upright. To test our scale, I'm going to put a couple of bouncy balls in one side of the scale, and then add a couple of blocks to the other side of the scale. The indicator still tilts to the left, so I'm going to add one more block and one more until it tilts a little bit to the right. Now I know that my 2 bouncy balls are heavier than 3 blocks, but lighter than 4 blocks. Thanks so much for joining us today. If you enjoyed this activity, please fill out a program survey in the description box below.